structure. So an app can be created like a completely independent module. For example, if you are creating a blog, separate module should be created for comments. Means if you are creating a blog post, so separate module you have to create a post, login and log out, etc. So there is a different apps for each task. Means one task is login, so you have to create different app for login. One task is log out, so you have to create different. So we have already done this project name, then after projects.name and then settings.py file. So in settings.py file, you will have we have a find installed app section. So app listed and installed apps are provided with developers. Like they are the apps that will be provided initially. So they could written something like this when we have created an app. So it would display something like this: dango.contribute.admin, authentication and content type, sessions, message, etc. Then how to create. So how to create, first we have to Python manage.py start app project app. Means whatever the project we have, we write the command like this. We are to create a basic app in your Django project, you need to go to the directory containing the manage.py. From there, enter the command this. Okay. Then after Django admin start app, before we write start project, here we are writing a start app because we are creating app, not the project. Means in a particular project, there are apps. Apps are like something different pages function, like login module, so it has some different functionality. So this is one app. Logout module, yeah, other register module. So these are some apps. So when you run this Django admin startup project app, you have given it name the project app. So what the directory structure? So first we go to the project name, and if we write a project, so we will find project name. Initially we get two, inside our project we get two files, one the project name and another is manage.py. Now we have created an app, so it will also create a folder, that is project app. Inside that folder we have migration, and inside that we have these files like admin.py, apps.py, models. So these are the files inside this. First we have directory should be something like, first we have project name. Inside our project name we have two folders and one file. One file is manage.py file, and two folders. One folder is for project folder and another is for app folder. So three files inside our main directory. It would something like this. Now to consider the app in your project, you need to specify your project name in this installed app list as settings.py. So inside project name, you have to go to this settings.py file. In that we have to mention our app name. So its command should be like, these are the command that actually we have initially. So what we could write here, project app. This is the install app. This app we have created. So this is the project app. Okay. We have given our app name project app. So we have finally created an app, but now we have to render as a URL.py file is used for every functional module. So what we will do here, we have to include our app in main project so that URLs redirect to that app can be rendered. So project name, then project names, then under urls.py file. Means we are going inside this url.py file inside the project folder, not inside the app folder. So we have to add there also. So first what we will do, from django.urls import include, we want to include this is header we use in Django. So it then inside the we have find some structure like this, from django.url import path comma include. Then after we have URL pattern. So in URL pattern, in lastly we have when created a hello function, we have right here path hello. Here we want to write path comma include. It's something like that. So it's path comma include project apps dot URL means we are linking the URL of project our app to the our website URLs file in this. So now you can use default MVT model to create URLs. So this is independent every the main thing is the main feature of Django apps is independent. Every app function is an independent unit in supporting the main project. Now Django forms, how to create Django forms. So it's like for whatever the functionality we have to add in our website, we have to create apps. So like we are discussing how to form Django. So forms, to create forms, first we need to create app because we are adding one functionality in it. So when one creates a form class, the most important part is defining the fields of form. Obviously, whenever we create any form, we need a field, means it is email, name, text, input, whatever the fields in us. So it is important that whenever we create a form, each field has a custom validation logic along with the new other rules. So taking input from the user in some manner and using the information for logical expression like registration. So this is something what we did in a form. So Django maps, Django maps the field defined in a Django form into HTML input fields. Django handles three distinct part of the work involved in a form. So first process what Django handling, preparing and restructuring data to make it easy for rendering means we have to collect the data. So Django help in it creating HTML form. So it's also create some, like we can use models for creating HTML forms and receiving and processing submitted forms from the data from the client. So collecting the information that the client was submitting. So it is something like this structure, like this is user. So user enters the details. What happened here, users first go through the request, okay? Then create empty, Django did it, create an empty form, user enters the details. Then after validate user request, then validate data. If data is validated, condition goes to it. If validated, then create empty form and user centered data. Otherwise, perform operation on data. If data is not validated, then data is validated, then perform data valid operations on data and request redirect to URL means whatever the operation is going on. It will redirect to the main page. Now for the syntax means how Django field work like models. So for the syntax like field name, forms dot field type options. So for do that, this is some syntax, like we have given the field name here, name. So field type like text like this. This is, so here we have write title is equals to forms, means we are importing first, we have to import the forms. So from Django import forms, then class Greeks form, we have created this form, forms dot form, like this form method we create the form. Then inside forms we have given a title, means this is the field name and it has value character field. Then after description, so it is also a value character field, means character value is going to be inserted here in a title and a description. So this is the basic syntax how we import the form forms and in Django. Like now using Django forms, to use Django forms one need to have a project and working on it. After you start an app, you can create an app/form.pyware. Like when we first created the here we have created the form with app. So project dot app, so inside this apps.py we have to create another file that was forms.py. Okay, so this is like how to do in Django. Apps forms.py. Before starting to use a form, let's check how to start a project and implement Django program. So first, what we are doing, creating a Django form. So to create a Django form, here we are using to input a registration form from one might need first name, roll number, and so on. So what we are doing here, from Django, import forms. Here we have given a form name, models dot, we are using here models, Django models, to import the form. So field name is equals to models dot field. This is the basic syntax, like title is equals to models dot character field. So this is the basic syntax. Now here we have created the file. Inside to create a form, inside our app, this is Greeks is our app folder. Inside this folder we have forms.py file. Then after, inside that folder, we are first what we will do, from Django import form. So we are importing the form. Then after, we are creating a form, we have given it name input form, because we want to take, you can give any name to this form, but we want to take the input from the user. So it's something like we have given it name input form. So what is here, forms.form, what is this is the module that we have imported from Django. Then after dot form, first name, this is our field name, and this is the type of field. So its max length should be, these are the optional characteristics, like max length should be 200, and for the last, similarly, inside roll number, what help text, these are the classes. So these are the predefined classes in our models of form. Help text, like enter 6-digit roll number, so it will display when you enter the field, it will display enter 6-digit roll number. And then the password, we have use widget dot form. So here, if I use password dot input, it will be come in an encrypted form, like the starred form. So whenever we enter the password, it will in a star form. So Django form field have several built-in methods to work the of the development, but sometimes one needs to implement things manually from the user interface. So a form comes with three built-in methods that can be used to render Django from field, like form as table, form as p, and form as ul. Means form, the data we collect could be collected in a table form, in a paragraph form, in a one particular data in a single paragraph, or we can collect in a list form. To render this form into a view, move to views.py and create a home view as blue. So we want to display it, means we want to show in our HTML. So what we'll do, we go to views.py, from Django dot shortcut, import render, because we want to render the data. Okay, from forms dot forms, import input form, and here we have given the class name input form. So I am importing, this is the forms file that we have created, forms.py, inside this app folder. And from that file, we are importing this class. We have that created for inserting the data. So we have created inside this function. This function, what we will do, it will display the our resultant on a screen, like what is the structure on a view page. So we have created home view, request, context. We have left it empty, context form, input form, because it's the form. Here some syntax is missing actually. So input form, then after return, render request, comma home dot HTML, comma context. So what will it do? Context, it will go, we have created first the empty dictionary here. Then after, inside this dictionary, we have given a field name form. So it input from data, means whatever the structure we have created in our forms.py file, it will display in our main page. Now what we need to do, after creating this file, we have to connect it with the URL files, because we already we have connected it, but if you don't connect with URL files, your data wouldn't be display on a screen. So this is editing ML, means this is the template using. So right now for the template is not, we are not working. So what if I run the localhost because I have already connected it with, so it will display something like this. So this is like we have created a form. Now what if you want to create Django form from the models, means in a Django we have some predefined models, so if you want to create for from them, this you can also do that. So to do that, first you have to import the standard Django model. So from django.db imports model, because we are importing database here. Then declare a new model with a name Greeks model. Okay, so this is some class. We have created a model inside our models file. This file where we are working, we have inside our app folder, we have create a models.py file. Okay, so inside that folder we are working on it. Then after we have given here title, description, last modify, so date, time, field, true, and the image. If image want to upload to, we have given the directory to where we want to upload the image. Then after creating the class, we have also created a cell function. So what will it return? It will return the title. Now to create a form directly for this model, dive into Greeks, like we have created greeksform.py, enter the following. So we don't want to, if we want to use model, then we don't want to use that view file. So from Django, import forms, and from dot models import Greeks model, because we have created a file there, and class Greeks form, and like we have called the method here. So what it will be output, it will if you run in a localhost, it will display the form, basic form. Okay, so here are some forms field that we use, that basic form data and field list. So the most important part of the form and only required part is the list of fields. Yes, because we need what kind of field type we are using. So to do that, we have first name is Boolean field. So it's a class Boolean field, and it's check HTML input. What it will do, checkbox input. So true, false, it's something like true, false. Character fields. So what will it input? Take input text input, like in, if we work on a HTML, we use text to input the data. So we use the input tag. So here what we will write to type the input, like a character field and type. In HTML we use type text, here we write character field. Choice field means selecting. Like we did in a select option, select drop down we have created in main if and HTML. So this is select option. So instead of using HTML and we are working on a model, so we use choice field. Then type choice field, so it's also some select, but it takes more than one value. Wait, one second. Then date field, so what it will take input, date input, and date time field, so date time input, decimal field, duration field, so it's text input, in email field, so it's email input, file field, so clearable file input, file path field, like selecting the file float. So these are the some image types of field that we are using, like when we create a website or a single page on using HTML. So we if you are working creating a form, then you are using some HTML tags, like input tag is used for taking an input in a form, and it has some different types. Types means which type of input you are taking, like character, string means text input, number input, date, time, or whatever the input you are taking. So the in models we use this syntax, like first we write the name of the field, then after models dot image field, other integer field, whatever the field you want, and then after we give some constraint. Means it is not necessary to give some constraint, but it's up to you. If you want to max length, give it to max length, make it password or something, so make it required. So these are the some general basic field that you could use in forms. So regex field, so it will take input as a text input. Yeah, now we can use, as I told you, required field option, like some constraint. If you want to use so required, so it make compulsory labeling, so to specify that this is the section for this contained label suffix widgets. Like we have in this file we have an example for widgets like password, so it's it could also be used for that. Help text, so it will help you, lets you specify descriptive text for this field, means for what this text field is we are using. So error messages will display the message what is if you are entering some forms, and if you are entering some wrong details, like you have to input in email but you forget it to add at sign or dot, or either you have to forget to enter the domain, so that's that will display the error message. Validator, so it validate arguments, let you provide a list of validation function. Localize, so enable the localization of form data input, like as well like placing the text where you want to look enter. And disable, so disable means it makes the field disable, you can't enter to that field. Now, how to convert a model into a Django form? So, as I have told you, we have created a model like this. We have created a model inside in our app folder. We have created a models.py file, and we write the code from Django.db import models and like this. Then after, if we have to run these two commands in our command prompt. So python manage.py make migration and python manage.py migrate. So it will first make migration, means first it will create your connect your URL, then after it will display the result, and then we have so to check the model has been successfully added, like we have our admin, then inside Greeks means this is our app, and Greeks model, that the function we have created here, Greeks model. So this is the model we have created, and write add slash add, because we want to check it is added or not. So if you display the form, it will display like this. So it will provide us model is like connecting to database, so it will provide us a database connection also. So we could also use make a form using models. So it has some proper UI also. Or you could also create using views.py file. So first you have to, yes, as I have displayed you home dot, first you have to connect it with the view file, then after you have to, if you run the program, so what will it display? Or it will display something like this, and inside a view file, what we will create, first we will create context, means first we have created a dictionary. Then we are doing here mapping form. Here we call the class Greek form class from the model. Here we have imported our model Greek form. These are the all the code that is written inside that view.py file of the app, not in a project file. We are writing all this code in the app main directory, then app folder. Then inside app folder we have view.py file. So inside that file we are working on this. So if form is validated, form.save, and what it will request, request home.html and context. So it's mapping with the model and it will display the view something like this. Yeah, and one advantage of using models is that whenever you submit the form, it will automatically save to database. You don't need to create another database, because models is like something connect your server or app with the database. So that is the profit of it. So here also I have field types like auto field, big auto field, big integer field, binary field, boolean field, so null, true, like that. These are the field that we use. URL field, like whatever the input we are taking, URL input, or from where we have to write it, like this is the model and this is the forms what we are writing. This is view file, so we are connecting. We could either display the form, model form, if we don't using connecting it with a form, forms.py, or we could either connect models with the view.py. So it's just up to you, you want to connect it with views or forms file. So this is a basic form creation in our Django. You guys try yourself. And for the PDF, I thought I will give you the whole PDF, means either I will share you the link where I am taking as resources, or I could share you these. I could also share you these PDFs, but they are not in a proper indentation, or maybe you could be, your code will not work. So yeah, I will share you the links of the sites where I am using, or either you have, I think you guys are all the technical persons, so most of you hear about the Greeks for Greeks and Java tipline and many of Java tutorial. So there are so many point websites that you could use, like Java tipline, Greeks for Greeks, and yeah, in W3 school we didn't have Django, it's only a Python. So you guys can use these files, use resources. Alright, anyone having doubt? Can you come take the attendance?
नेक्स्ट
क्लास आपको भी 4 बजे से स्टार्ट करनी है, तो अभी कर दीजिए, रात सभी क्लास रहेगी, वो लिंक मैंने भेज दिया था।
ओके ओके मैम,
हाँ ठीक है।